Okay, this is Madonna. And she says, "Stars." I'm here at Barnes & Noble, and I went in El Segundo. It's a great wine. It's one of my favorites. And I've just done the comic book convention. I'm Los Angeles Comic Book Convention. I wanted to follow up this thing with trends. I'm here. GQ Style is the first wine that sort of really comes out, and it has actor Cillian Murphy on it. Looks like maybe on the cover. I could be wrong, but it says very bankable Tom. Obviously what you want to do, and obviously it's maybe, well, I've seen his face. I don't know his name, first up. And that is sometimes the first way you meet celebrity. What I want to talk about is style and trend. And so what I saw at the comic book convention and how it relates to what I see on this GQ Style. This is sometimes how I see comic books, and this is sometimes how I see comic book trade. Sort of a thing that puts you together, being something of a style and also something that would keep them sort of come of age to become something grown, something that's acceptable and something that's mainstream. If you come to any type of decision about things that are considered to be, I don't know, not mainstream, not really socially acceptable, or something that's sort of downtrodden, come to a place where things are upfront, like Barnes & Noble, and you will see these things thrown back at you in a way that you can articulate. And you will see that the things that you thought were not you, were not for you, or things that they think are not for people, or of people, or about people, are really all and for and about people everywhere. And that's where you can come to a better understanding of why you're moved by pop culture, or any culture, in any style, and why it's important to look at trends in these sort of areas, arenas, where they think it's not that very popular. It's totally false. It's totally moving things forward. And here, I see nothing but comic books. And it's GQ Style, and fall winter 2019, what to wear now. And it has, looks like, three top names on it. Cillian Murphy, Tyson Jones, and Larry Gagosian. Okay? And they're very bankable. And it looks very bankable. Okay? And ultimately, money, they think, is the bottom line. But really, what's bottom line is your presentation, what you hope to learn, and what you hope to share. Okay, so I'm going to talk a little bit about that, maybe after I look around, because I always come here looking for stuff, but this time I want to tie it together, so maybe those that are following me can maybe follow me in another way, and they could come here to Barnes & Noble, and they can see what moves them. It'll be different covers, different magazines, different styles, but ultimately telling them the bottom line, what's good for them, what's good for society, in their eyes, and also what society thinks is good for them, which is not necessarily in their eyes. And that's where you get commentary. I want this magazine. I don't want this magazine. I want to find this book. How can I make it more? How can I leave with a package of items geared for me? Maybe periodicals, short stories, hardcovers, softcovers. I mean, they have everything, okay? If you don't know what you're looking for, go to the information book, information booth, and you can find it. And one thing that you have to figure out is how to deal with disruption. And people such as the lady who walked in front or whatever, not saying excuse me, is a commentary on sort of culture, how you can say excuse me and thereby teach someone. Now, coming in into sort of like talking about books or whatever, you sort of have an opportunity to sort of look at, are they open to my commentary or what? Do they really care or not? Is there freedom of press, freedom of voice, freedom of the right to speech? True or not, okay? If you think people are going to toss you out or whatever, and you can get the vibe, I'm very strong. It sort of tells you a little bit about the store. Barnes & Noble is supposed to be open. It's supposed to be a bookshop open to all types of people to buy the books. If you get a strong vibe, you are not welcome. That means your point of view is not welcome. And that means that already half of these books are not viable, not acceptable, and not being purchased, and not being looked at. It comes into a form of ism. And whatever you choose to call it, you will know by the time you leave. Okay? I still come here anyway. It's because I choose to. Right? This is LaDonna with the And She Sells Stars, and at Barnes & Noble in El Segundo.